Hey, good evening, everybody. This is going to be a short video, if Mother Nature allows, for the Phillies and Nationals game, which is supposed to start at 7:05. I would say, looking at the weather, there's a slim chance of it starting on time, but maybe we could still get it in some capacity. For the Nationals, their lineup is going to be Trey Turner today, Juan Soto, Howie Kendrick, Estrubel Cabrera, Eric Thames, Adam Eden, Yan Gomes, youngster Luis Garcia, and Michael A. Taylor. Where for the Phillies, it's going to be Andrew McCutchen, Rhys Hoskins, Bryce Harper, JT Realmuto, Didi Gregorius, Gene Segura, Jay Bruce, youngster Alec Boehm, and hot swinging Roman Quinn. So, the Phillies are obviously, they did very good scoring in yesterday's game. They battled all the way back, but their pitching failed them. They added a new pitcher today in David Phelps, who has been one of the better pitchers, has a below 3 ERA since 2016, and limits hard contact. He has one of the lowest hard contact percentages in all of baseball since that time as well. So he was a very good pickup. We did give up three young pitchers, three of them for David Phelps, which might be a little bit of a stretch. But I think it was three guys that were in single A. They might not develop. It could become a trade that was similar to Freddie Peralta, where he got good for the Brewers, where they made a trade, which was the Adam Lind trade years ago, where it was like two or three people for Lind, and then one of those pitchers ended up panning out. But either way, if Phelps pitches really well for this Phillies team, as he's been doing, and he helps us to get farther this year and get in the playoffs for the first time since our last runs, and actually do something in the playoffs, I don't think anyone's going to care down the line about all the prospects, unless if one of them changes or turns into one of the best pitchers in the game, which they're not that high of ceiling prospects, so that would have to really, they really have to propel their game in the next couple years. So I like that move. I think that move really helps add to Workman, who we have already. We have now Phelps, we have another David and David Hale, and then you got, of course, Heath Hembray. So we're adding people in. Ranger Suarez is also supposed to be fairly close to coming back. So Robertson got a setback, which is unfortunate, but Suarez is supposed to be close to come back, which is big because Morgan hasn't looked too good recently, so you might get rid of him as a lefty and put Suarez in and have Suarez and Alvarez, but we'll see what happens there. Morgan's got to start getting going. But either way, obviously the keys to tonight's game are you got Spencer Howard on the mound against Eric Fetty. Neither of these pitchers have really any much experience. Obviously, Fetty has pitched in 41 games in his career, but it hasn't been very good. He has a 5.14 ERA. This is his first year he's actually had pretty good numbers. In six games, he's 1-2 with a 3.57. But still has a 1, so he has a 1.54 whip, which isn't bad. But that means you can still get at least a hit on him per inning. And with the Phillies, if you get a walk and get a home run, sometimes that's how their offense gets going. Fetty's a guy that can be susceptible to that for sure. What we need to see from Spencer Howard if we're able to play tonight with Mother Nature is more intensity as he goes throughout the game. He seems to tire, and I think he's a guy we need to see start getting past the fourth inning, start getting into the fifth inning, start progressing as the season goes on. But that's not 100% on him, because I think he could have got out of the last, or could have got out of that inning his last start. So it's also on the coaching staff to reel back that leash a little bit, especially in a 60-game season. If you want to be able to do something and you're adding bullpen pieces like you think you're going to be able to do something this year. Otherwise, Glenteck's just tired of getting talked about in the media by Joe Girardi. So it's either he's finally stepping up to try to win, or he's just doing it because his manager's going to insult him to the media if he does. So either way, though, we made the moves, and they should help our team. So now it's on the Phillies to keep progressing and getting better. You should not have a game like yesterday now with these guys in your bullpen, because if Neers can get going, which is an if because he's been very off this year, you got Hector, you got Hembray, you got Hale, who's a solid pitcher, but he's a guy that if he can get going, now you got Phelps, and then if Tommy Hunter can do decent, then you have four okay relievers. Reggie McClan's what you get. He's a guy that has good movement and stuff, he's just never been able to figure it out, but this bullpen should help propel this team now to have that better offense and to be able to win some of these games where our starters don't do really good. I don't think we're going to see as many games like yesterday now that we added to this bullpen. And I think that'll help because if we look at yesterday, Hembray, he came in and struggled as one of our new guys. Velasquez pitched a good two innings, which was great to see. So if you can get Vinny Velo going out of the bullpen, Reggie McClan pitched meh, and then JoJo got a strikeout and a walk, so he's looked pretty solid as a lefty. And Blake Parker has continued to pitch very well. So I forgot about Parker. You also have Parker in there who's been our best reliever since coming up. So as long as you have at least five or six guys in your pen you can count on, which the Phillies now have at least five or six guys. Two of them might be guys that you're like, okay, we could probably count on them. But that's very helpful, especially now that you've got Suarez coming back. And if Vinny Velasquez can start pitching with that intensity, 35 pitches per two innings, that's about fine. And get you a couple innings each time he's in. That's really going to help. So my keys for tonight are, of course, our offense is continuing to bat. Spencer Howard building on his last start and getting better. And last but certainly not least, our bullpen and the guys we got to continue to get better themselves. Hembray has only had one good outing since coming in. Workman's got saves, but they weren't painless to say the least. So we need to see those guys come in and be the guys we brought in, not struggle. So that's another key. But have a great, safe, and pleasant day, everybody. If Mother Nature allows, enjoy the game. Peace out, everyone.